Without further ado, these are our kids. Unplugged Christmas.
Christmas spirit. Oh gosh, I hope it didn't make you late. Oh, my. Everything looks so festive. Y'all must be real excited. Oh, not a problem, dearie. When your son runs the local TV station, you tend to get the 911 on these kinds of things. We'll see you after the show.
I think she made that 411.
I can still hear you.
So small, no one will ever see it.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ, the Lord. And this is a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
To make me a judge for the biggest, brightest Christmas show ever. Imagine that. Merry Christmas!
Wow, can you believe it? Miss Taylor wants to see your judge.
They were like children who ruined everything.
No, Seth. Everything was exactly perfect. I do have a question, though. When the lights went out, why did the stars stay on?
I don't know. They looked like they're valid. It just never blew out.
It may have been a little star, but in the dark, you can sure see that star shine.
Like God wants us to shine.
Hey, everyone. Now that everything is working, we still have one more rockin' carol to sing. Let's finish the story.
Kids.